Hello and welcome to the ICSE Class 10 Mathematics tutorial. The topic is Probability, Part 2. Part 1 we have already done. So before we start, आइए आपको एक शायर की दो लाइन सुनाता हूं. शायर कहता है, न कोई अहद निभाए न हम नवाई करे. अहद प्रॉमिस, हम नवाई, चाइम इन, सुर में सुर मिलाना, हा में हा मिलाना. हम नवा का मतलब साथी, हम नवाई, हा में हा मिलाना. न कोई अहद निभाए न हम नवाई करे. न कोई अहद निभाए न हम नवाई करे. उसे कहो कि तसल्ली से बेवफाई करे. उसे कहो कि तसल्ली से बेवफाई करे. शुक्रिया. Thank you. Now let's start. As I told you in part one, I have explained all those important points and the definition of probability, like experiment, random experiment, event, sample space, sample points, everything I've explained in part one. Today, we are going to solve question based on tossing a coin. So let's take a question. The question is, I'm reading out the question. An unbiased coin is tossed. Find the probability of getting a hit. An unbiased coin is tossed. You have to find out the probability of getting a hit. That is the question. Okay. First of all, you know, when we toss a coin, this is the coin. One side hit, the other side tilt. When you toss a coin, the possible outcomes are hit or tilt. So this is a sample space. S, capital S is equal to, within the curly bracket, HT. Then we write down number of sample points in S, that is N of S is equal to 2. 1, 2. 2. Then let E is equal to, R event is getting a hit on the uppermost face. Alright, when we are tossing a coin, unbiased coin. So let E is equal to event that hit turns up. Let E is equal to event that hit turns up. Or let E is equal to event of getting a hit on the uppermost face. Alright. And that is C. That you write down in the form of set. So H. Only one sample point. Alright. So N of E is equal to 1. Got it? So we know N of E, we know N of S. And the definition, you know, which we have done in part 1, probability of E is equal to, probability of E is equal to, so now we write down probability of E, alright, so probability of E is equal to N N of E upon N of S. This is the formula. Alright. And N of E is 1. N of E is 1. And N of S is 2. So the answer is 1 upon 2. This is the answer. This is the answer. 1 upon 2 is the answer. So easy. Right. Let's take another question. Next question. Alright, this was first question. Alright. Answer is 1 by 2. Now next question, second question. Second question, I've taken two identical coins are thrown. two identical coins are thrown simultaneously, find the probability of getting, first sub question, at least one tail, second sub question, at the most one tail. The important is to understand the meaning of at least or and at the most. This is important to understand. Once you understand the meaning of at least, because here only the students make mistake. What's the meaning of at least and what's the meaning of at the most? This we need to understand. Okay, so two sub questions. Again, I'm telling you, two coins are being tossed, identical coins, simultaneously, and we have to find out the probability first of getting at least one tail, and second, at the most one tail. Fine. Two identical coins are tossed. So first of all, let's write down the sample space. When two coins are tossed, how shall we write down the sample space? Let us see. Two coins are tossed. So two coins are tossed means on both the coins, you get HH. Alright, or maybe HT. Or maybe TH. Or TT. Or TT. Alright, first coin hit, second coin also hit on the uppermost face. First coin showing hit, but the second coin tail. First tail, second hit, and both tail. These are the possibilities. So this will be your S. Alright, these are the possible outcomes. Alright, sample points. What is N of S? Therefore, N of S is equal to. Therefore, N of S is equal to how much? 4. N of S is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now let. Our event is what? Let. Let E is equal to. What is the event? The event is at least one tail. At least one tail. Now this you need to understand. At least one tail. E is equal to event of getting. You write down full. Event of getting at least one tail. Event of getting at least one tail. This is our first sub question. Alright. Okay. So this is equal to how much? At least one tail. At least one tail. What's the meaning of that? At least one tail means maybe more than one. Alright. No. Sometimes when you go to somebody's house and then your auntie says, please have at least one chapati. At least one chapati means at least one. You can have more than one. Take at least one toffee. Take at least one samosa. At least one samosa means minimum one. You can take more than one. At least one samosa. At the most is different. Right now we understand the meaning of at least. So please have at least one samosa. That means you can have more than one. Alright. So here at least one tail. That means minimum one tail. Minimum one tail should be there. There could be more than one. There could be more than one. So at least one tail. At least one tail. So HT, TH, and TT. Are you okay with it? So N of E is equal to, therefore N of E is equal to how much? 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, 3. N of E. and therefore the probability of E is equal to Ne upon Ns. Alright, therefore the probability of E therefore the probability of E, we can write down here only, the probability of E is equal to any upon NS. Alright. Any upon NS. N is how much? 3. N is 3 and NS is 4. So 3 upon 4 you are getting. 3 upon 4. N upon NS. 3 upon 4 is the answer. Probability of A in this case. Got it? Now this is first sub question. This is the first sub question. Alright. This is your first sub question. Now in the second sub question, we have to find out the probability of getting at the most one tail. At the most one tail. Now again you understand. Practical example. You can have at the most 2 ice cream. You can have at the most 2 samosas. At the most 2 samosas. Maximum 2 samosas, right? At the most 1 tail means maybe not even a single samosa. But if you are taking, at the most you can take 2 samosas. At the most 2 samosas means maybe 2, maybe 1, maybe 0. If you are taking a samosa, you can take at the most 2 samosas. Alright. At the most. At the most 3 chapatis, at the most 4 puris, you can take at the most 4 puris, you can take at the most 5 pani puris, at the most 5, means it could be 4 also, it could be 3 also, it could be 2 also, it could be 1 also, it could be 0 also, but maximum 4, at the most 4, it cannot be more than that. So in our question it is at the most one tail. At the most one tail, that means tail cannot be more than one. There may not be any tail, but it cannot be more than one. At the most one tail. So second sub question. Now second sub question is, in our second sub question, understand, second sample space will remain the same. N of S will remain the same. Let E is equal to event of getting at the most. Now here you will write down at the most one tail. At the most. At the most. At the most one tail. At the most one tail means maximum one tail. Alright. So maximum one tail means there cannot be two tails. Alright. So we can write down then HH, HT and TH. HH, HT and TH. So HH, HT and TH. At the most one tail, maximum one tail. This is important. This you need to understand the meaning of at the most and at least. At the most one. Now the interesting is in both the cases you will see that N of E is 3. Now you tell me, without writing all these things, if you are writing directly in both the cases, the answer is 3 upon 4, you tell me, should you be given marks? because we don't know whether you are writing e this or this, the earlier one. In both the cases, n of e is 3, but there we have taken tt in place of hh, because there the question was you end up getting at least one tail. So at least one tail means ht, th and tt, and here it is at the most one tail means hh, ht and th. In both the cases n of e is 3, so that means the writing down the event showing this is important in the set form. Alright. Otherwise, in both the cases, you will get n of e is equal to 3. But here, the set is different. Event is different. Event is different. Here, it is hh, ht, th. And there it was ht, th and tt. Ht, th and tt. Right. So, n of e is equal to 3. And therefore, probability of e is equal to n e upon ns is equal to 3 upon 4. This is the answer for the second sub-question. Got it? Understood? I hope things are very, 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 very clear. The important is to understand the meaning of at the most and at least. Hope everything is clear. Thank you so much. Thanks. Now, in my next lecture, we will be talking about throwing a six-face die. Throwing a six-face die. Fine? Okay then, thank you so much. Thanks.